With all our hearts, we pray and ask, God bless Anambra, God bless the shining light that we bear. We're the only ones to make her brighter, the only ones to make her better, the only ones to make Anambra shine. With our sweat and blood, every breath.
Honorable Commissioner, we've talked about the primary health of Anambra State. Let's talk about secondary health. What's the government's plan, its focus, and its direction for 2019?
Well, thank you very much. We have about 85 general hospitals in the state, and which when we started, most of them are in various states of spread. And what the government did was to select three of them to which one to lift the status of specialist hospital. The essence of this is there are only two teaching hospitals in the state, so we wanted to upgrade the general hospitals to the standard of specialist hospital that can augment the work of the teaching hospital so that the transit time and the time that people spend in the hospital
will be reduced.
We selected general hospital in general hospital, and I'm sure that if you go to general hospital, you will see almost about rounding the challenge. I was calculated at the elephant, you know, where we get that we can.
That people can actually use and then get to the hospital.
Oh,
good.
And what actually has delayed was eventually we felt that we should also introduce standard accident and emergency. You know, so we're building that one as an exclusive unit that will serve the helipad. And that one is going to be, you know, commissioned in less than 1 month or so.
So the project has been completed?
Yes, it has been completed. So we're going to address the issue of the manpower. So that's when you're going to get through. That of the program has come far. The Enugu General Hospital also on them.
Okay.
And that's how it is. And in the general hospitals, we want to have general hospitals that should be up to work standard in terms of the human resources, in terms of the equipment, and then in terms of the operation. And that was why we started thinking of how do you partner with people outside Nigeria or within.
Okay.
So we now have private public partnership. This is the first thing that we have. We started with the group from California, the Sunrise Clinic, that we partner, which we equipped, and we're managing the general hospital at Urumba. In as much as we have some pitches, because we are still, you know, doing the much we can, compared to the best we can.
Okay.
You know, getting the civil servants, you know, to accept the way private people do is not an easy thing. But we saw that at the time we're gonna build a midline. And that's the best way we have to function.
With all this
private initiative into a public system to move faster.
Okay. With all these equipments, I'm happy you mentioned civil servants, and it's a general hospital. Can civil servants also afford quality healthcare services in those hospitals, or is for bourgeois now?
No, you see, I remember we mentioned health insurance scheme. The health insurance scheme is where you pay a small money that's covering over time. And when you are sick, you choose the hospital you need. So this time around, we are choosing hospital based on the quality of the hospital.
Okay.
And the level of service they have.
Okay.
So they will eventually be collecting a uniform amount of money.
Okay.
But the difference is that the hospital that is doing better, we have more
numbers. More numbers, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
By this, we are standardizing the hospitals. And remember that in this health insurance, we are paying capitation directly to the hospitals, depending on the number of patients. So it now helps hospitals to develop both private and public. But the money is paid directly to the hospitals, enabling them to improve. And if you're not improving, the patient will not go there. And you die naturally. So we have created a kind of competition for hospitals to thrive, you know, to move to the standard that could be acceptable to the people.
This is an accident and emergency building, one of the numerous projects we have in this hospital. The contract is for renovation of the whole general hospital in Onitsha. But this one is one of them, accident and emergency building. Well, the project, I think within 1 month from now, I think we'll be through with the project. These are doctor's quarters. We have two units, doctor's quarters 1 and 2. These are under projects we started and finished under this contract. And we have other buildings too. We have over the isolation center, and you have the call room where you, if you have a case of Ebola or other communicable diseases, they can quarantine them there. The doctors can use the call room there. We have other buildings we renovated. This one, male ward. Then behind it, we have the male chest ward. Then over there, we have a female chest ward. Then if you go down, we have the female medical ward there and the female chest ward. Then admin building is down there as well. We have the store. We counted like 15 buildings renovated in this building, in this hospital.
There was a fire incident in Enugu a while ago that rained down a morgue and lost bodies were reburnt. What led to an incident like that, and what's the ministry doing to ensure that we don't have a repeat of incidences like this?
Yes, I can tell you that if we were to take from the ministry, and yes. I will tell you that the ministry would have been described by the people who saw tomorrow.
Okay.
Because before that incident, we started training the morticians. We formed Mortician Association of Anambra State, the first in West Africa. Why did I do so? Well, there was certain having emergence of communicable disease, Ebola, Lassa fever, and the exit of every illness is through the
bed.
And they have to pass through the mortuary.
Yes.
Okay, so if you don't check mortuary and teaching them how to control those things, it could be another focus of epidemics and what that one would sit. I had experience with Lassa fever when a cost was bust in Tuna Anambra State at the employees in Atlanta. Okay, somebody from Liberia. And I know what to do. It was in the morgue when we went there and cordoned everybody and quarantined both, you know, and you know how we managed it. So before then, we have formed a Mortician Association, you know, telling them what and what should be done. And one of the things that happened was, even what we told them, that you don't keep those chemical preservatives because they're highly inflammable. You don't put them inside.
In the same space.
In the same space.
Yes.
And that was the other one happened.
Okay.
Because you want, at the end of Google, you never knew, nobody actually knew where the car was going to be. That way, it was like a British one, you know, by the side of the park, and eventually, you know, went to the monitor, and then what did you know, got into film within a, you know, within a minutes, because most of the things that are in, you know,
so this is the only psychiatric hospital in Anambra State. So we basically can cater for the mentally ill, but we admit patients and we also treat outpatients. In addition to that, we serve as a training center for nursing students. Nursing students come here for their 6-week mental health nursing program. So in the past 2 years, the hospital has undergone a lot of physical transformation. The government has put in a lot of money to renovate the facilities and to provide some equipment to enable us to do carry out this great responsibility. So we are very grateful. First of all, we are very grateful to the government for the renovation, because prior to 2016, when I came here, there were a lot of buildings were run down, patients and relations were complaining. But at least now, when they come, they are delighted to see the equipment, the structures and the environment. Okay, we now have a borehole, which was given by the House of Assembly member. And then with the renovation, at least the place is a bit more comfortable and conducive.
With all our hearts, we pray and ask, God bless Anambra, God bless the shining light that we bear. We're the only ones to make her brighter, the only ones to make her better, the only